I was a black girl, therefore I wasn't smart. I'm doing it, you know, and that's really what drives me, because I recognize I do have the capacity and the capability to really get my education. Hi, welcome to the first episode of 22 and Graduated. I am Ree Botts from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I did my undergraduate at Spelman College, where I obtained my bachelor's degree in sociology and anthropology. And I'm currently a graduate student at UCLA studying African American studies and anthropology. Originally from Philadelphia, and so growing up in Philly, transitioning to being in Atlanta for Spelman, I just learned so much about myself as a black woman. I was inspired to figure out who it was that I was created to be. And that's really what inspired the Selfology movement, which is a movement that I founded this past summer. I'm in the process now of writing my book of poetry that just speaks to what it is that the Selfology movement is all about. And in thinking through who I am as a black woman, what I was called to do, I came up with the Selfology movement, which is all about the body, the mind, the soul, the ancestry, and the spirituality. I think it's so important for us as black women to know that we are not our bodies, right? We're so much more than what the eye can see. And so the Selfology movement is inspiring women to dig deeper beyond the surface level and to figure out like what it is that we are, who it is that we are. And for me, my story is encompassed in these five layers of Selfology, and my body is what people see first. And so people always judge me based on how I looked, as most of us, right? Like, we're always put into other people's boxes based on who we appear to be. And I was also sexually abused when I was 12 years old, and that experience also impacted how I knew my body, how I existed in my body, and also my skin color, being black but also being light skinned, right? A lot of my research that I do is on colorism and just understanding what are the stereotypes that people have of me based on my visible appearance. And so all of that goes into how I, as a 23-year-old woman, have understood what my body is and what my body means to me.
Yeah.
And I'm from Philly. I'll show y'all
what
how I do me. Being a scholar has been so important to me, but when I was younger, I used to be told like, you aren't smart because you're black. And I went to predominantly white high school, and I remember a moment when one of my classmates, I had my hand raised to answer a question in history class, and one of my white classmates put my hand down and said like, you don't need to speak. And so I felt so silenced in that moment, and that was a lot of what my experience was, that I got all A's in school, but I wasn't smart because I was a black girl. And when I went to Spelman for the first time, I embraced the fact that I'm a scholar. I never thought I was smart enough to go to graduate school to get a PhD, but it was through my experience with Spelman and being accepted to the UNCF Mellon Mays Fellowship, which basically paid me to think and paid me to do research and allowed me to travel to South Africa and expand my research in a new way. And for me, that was so empowering, because I realized there were other black women who were my professors and my mentors that believed in me, that thought I was smart enough to get a PhD. And now I'm here at UCLA chasing that goal, chasing that dream. And for everyone who told me I couldn't because I was a black girl, therefore I wasn't smart, I'm doing it.
Told me our lives were worth living, so we embraced the endless possibilities of a lifetime. We, the little girls who wandered about the world since pigtails draped in ribbons, since knee highs and pressing curls, we became the young women who wandered about the world as if those same little girls still lived in us.
Because I recognize I do have the capacity and the capability to really get my education. So what I want to do with my PhD is become a professor of Africana studies, ideally teach at Spelman and Morehouse. That would be my dream, because I love the HBCU experience. I had such a wonderful time while I was at Spelman and Morehouse, and I think that to be able to give back to my community and give back what I've learned in spaces like UCLA to prepare the next generations of scholars. And so next is the soul. I've learned a lot in my experiences with other black women that we might be confident in the way we look, and we might be confident in our resumes, but we still haven't connected with ourselves. And a lot of times there's so many black women who are super successful, but don't know themselves. And so a part of this movement too is about encouraging women to always be yourself in every space that you enter. No matter how far up the ladder you climb, no matter who you become, remember you have to stay true to you. You have to be connected in here internally and know that it's not just what's on the outside and it's not just what's up here, but it's also what's in here. And that's what allows you to be compassionate. That's what allows you to connect with other women and really see who they are, because you've taken the time to see who you are. And so for me, the soul is so important, because it's challenging Black women to say, well, who are you really? You know, like, what is at the core of who you were created to be? That's your destiny. That's your purpose. And beyond the soul is the ancestry. My tattoo is called the Sankofa bird. And so I learned about this when I traveled abroad in Ghana. I studied abroad for 4 months while I was at Spelman. And so what this means is go back and fetch it. And this is so powerful because it means chase your ancestry. Learn about where your people come from. Learn about the other Black women who came before you and survived so that you could live, so that you could exist and thrive in the way that you're thriving right now. And that's what keeps me going, is that I know that those women live within me. Those women's veins, you know, within my veins, their blood is running through my veins, and that's what keeps me going. I know that my purpose is not just about my own body, mind, soul, but about theirs as well. I'm a continuation of their legacy. And so I call on them when I'm down and out, right? In those moments when I feel like I can't make it, I don't have what it takes to go on, I remember, you know, like, they're on my shoulder. I'm carrying them on my shoulder. They got my back. I can do whatever it is that I need to do, whatever it is that I was called to do, because God created me for this special purpose. And so I have to live out my purpose. They're counting on me to live out my purpose. And the last aspect, the last layer, is the spirituality. And for me, my spirituality is deeply rooted in a faith in a God that protects me. I believe that if I can't find protection from this world, I can't find protection from other people, I know that my destiny is designed just for me. And so with that, I can do whatever it is that I was called to do, because that's what I was created to do, right? A lot of times we think, oh, well, I don't have what it takes to become whatever this dream in my mind is to become. But if God put that in your heart, if that's what you were really called to do, you can't not have what it takes. Maybe you haven't taken the time to look within yourself and find what it is that you do have within yourself to reach that goal. And so overall, the Selfology movement is just designed to speak to Black women, to Black girls, and say, like, let's start finding ourselves. Let's start being honest about who we are, how we became who we are today, and not lose ourselves. Running across the sea, sailing away in the sunset, chasing our souls to the shorelines, feeling like 10 and 22 and infinity at the exact same time, like this. Whole world was created just for us. Like, this is exactly how growing up should feel. Be sure to check out my website, www.reeseology.com, for more information. Again, that's www.reeseology.com.